Imagine a machine that can create anything out of a spool of material. A machine that is more accurate and more environmentally friendly than any other industrial method of creation. If you already know about this machine, called 3D printing, you might think that the possibilities are limited to small household appliances. A paper towel roll, some Legos maybe. Certainly not a fully functioning boat, or even a model of a Boeing. Because 3D printing is not confined to that 10 by 10 centimeter space anymore, or even confined to just plastic. I mean, we can print insane houses, hearts, and even human bones. The possibilities are truly endless, and this, coupled with the environmental benefits, really gives some perspective onto the potential and the future of 3D printing. We are living in the future, but the origins of 3D printing are deeply rooted in our history. Because believe it or not, we as humans have been printing and creating for over 32,000 years. We started with simplistic cave paintings, then we moved on to tablets, and then paper, and next in line is printing solid objects, printing in the third dimension. And this idea seems outlandish, but the first prototype model of a 3D printer was actually developed in 1980 by Chuck Hull. Of course, back then, 3D printers were limited by size and the high level of inaccuracy among most printers. Also, some printers, like early computers, could take up the whole room, and the cost of the printers themselves, plus the plastic needed to run them, were very astronomically high. But here's the thing, 3D printing is always growing, always adapting. And with the increased affordability of printers, the community has grown to be global. For example, the printer I own now would have costed about $2,000 a few years ago, but I got mine last year for just over $200. Nowadays, 3D printers have about the footprint of a modern computer, and the environmental footprint of the printer itself is actually very low. But how is this possible? A 3D printer's main function is to extrude plastic material, so shouldn't it add to the plastic crisis? Well, not exactly. See, the issue isn't really with the plastic itself, it's with the plastic waste from humans. And that's where 3D printing starts to become a viable solution. The way most manufacturing takes place is that plastic is dumped into a mold and the excess is cut off by machinery. That excess is then dumped into oceans and landfills, contributing to the plastic issue and poisoning and trapping poor organisms in the ocean, about 1 million of them each year. The way 3D printing works is that it only uses about as much plastic as necessary. Not only this, but according to ourworldanddata.com, 37 million tons of plastic waste in 2015 were produced simply from household dysfunctional items. 3D printing can allow us to replace parts from these items instead of just tossing them out. For example, when I lost the back case to my mouse in 2020, it became virtually unusable. Without a back case, the mouse wouldn't lay steady on a desk, and the company sold no replacement parts. The sites from China which did would take a long time to arrive and cost a lot in shipping, so the better fiscal decision would be to throw the mouse away and buy a new one. However, I used my 3D printer to design and print a back case for my mouse to replace it. The plastic crisis has had a huge effect on the environment, but there's a new issue on the horizon, and it has to do with face masks. Not specifically the usage of the face mask, but more so the waste left behind by them. According to Denver Channel News, roughly 1.5 billion masks were estimated to be left behind in 2020. The reason why this is significant is because masks can actually stay in the ocean for multiple years due to the rubber and metal clippings inside of them. Spain-based company called La Factoria 3D produced a model for a reusable plastic mask and posted it on Thingiverse, a website with over 1.6 million free user-created designs. This mask has many benefits, but the most important two are that you can clean out the inside with soap and water, allowing for multi-personal use, and also you could change the filters, which made it even more secure for multi-personal use. The reason why people did not use these masks is because they felt that it was not as reliable as the fabric masks. They felt that it's not as effective. However, FutureMedicine.com released a research paper that they made, which shows that the plastic masks have a total inward leakage of about 58%. Whereas the fabric masks have a total inward leakage of around 45%. For reference, an N95 respirator mask has a total inward leakage of anywhere from 70 to 80%. Total inward leakage measures how much of the contaminant is kept outside of the mask. so the greater total inward leakage, the better the mask is. 3D printing has truly just gotten started, and the benefits are already insane. I mean, think about what we will be able to accomplish given 50, even 100 years. The possibilities are truly endless as long as we continue to look beyond, innovate, and make 3D printing more and more accessible. Thank you.